Right, here we are at Landgoed Huizen Almelo, and apparently there is something really interesting in these woods here, and it's something from World War II. So I already know where it is, but let's have a little bit of a look around here, because apparently there is a some sort of V1 rocket launch installation in this area. So I already know it's somewhere behind there, so we're going actually to the road again, because we have to go just a little bit further ahead. I visited the installation a few months ago in the summer. At the time it was kind of hot and busy, so I think it's a better moment to look at it now, as it's now the Christmas vacation. Well, as you can see, there's some kind of embankment here, but as far as I'm aware, it has nothing to do with the V1 installation. But yeah, it is somewhere in these woods. Just have to walk a few hundred meters and then get in there, and then we should be able to find it relatively quickly. So anyway, I visited that thing in the summer, so I already know what it looks like and roughly where it is. So let's hope I can find it again. And I think I've already found it. Yes, just take a very good look at this place, because here it is. I already see a little bit of concrete, and there she is. This concrete slab here is the foundation of a V1 installation. This is where the Germans had plans to launch rockets. As you can see, there is some sort of holes and some sort of track arrangement. And this is not everything, because right here is some kind of pit made of concrete. And as you can see, it's fairly close to the road. This one is rather easy to find once you know exactly where it is. And it doesn't end here. If you go a little bit further, we'll see even more concrete foundation with these sort of inlets. We see these sort of holes here, and they were used for the steel structure. And there's a few more of them actually. So let's have a look at all of them. They all have the same size and dimension and the same sort of arrangement. And then we reach the last two one, and they are actually split. Instead of being one piece with two holes, it's just now one piece with one hole in it. So I don't know why they've done that. And if that foundation is any different or deeper, I have no idea. But yeah, I think it's kind of odd to see. And I think this is the last one. I don't think there's any more behind here. I mean, you could perhaps get onto the track behind there, because there is supposed to be also a path in this forest. Let's see if I can actually reach the footpath, whether we are any close. Don't think we are, but I don't know. Oh hey, actually this is the footpath. Hey, that's interesting. You can also reach it from this footpath, but you just have to know that you have to go in there. So yeah, that was kind of short, and that's about it. But yeah, this is the Nijrace Bos, and apparently the Germans had plans to build like a rocket launch installation to which they could reach various objectives. And this is not the only place in Overijssel where they had V1 launch sites. There were many others. Apparently they also had one in Borne, somewhere in the Twickel area, and they had one in Rijssen. There's some websites where you can find them, but yeah, this is the only one that I know of that I have actually seen myself. Yeah, the rest of this forest is just part of Landgoed Huizen Almelo, and this goes on for a bit, and it's actually quite an interesting little forest, even though it's not particularly big. But yeah, supposedly there should also be like a second lawn site here. At least I've read something about that. But yeah, I don't know where that one is. This one is really well known and really well documented. Everybody knows about this one. So yeah. So that was a rather short video, but yeah, I hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching.